Very got, serious indeed.
No, I got this some mic. I mean, yeah, some people call me. And I don't know what them look like, you know.
See me, someone said hello to me. I couldn't tell you who the person was. I mean, said, oh, how are you doing? I said, I'm fine. I didn't know who it was.
And my wife, and I looked at him, I said, yeah, man, everything crisp, man. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but we live in interesting times. So, yeah. Here we are.
Yeah, we're going to play one more tune before we
So you want to borrow some of my time?
Well, if you don't mind, sir.
Yeah, I'll give you 5 minutes, yes?
Yeah, give me 5 minutes.
But yeah, take it back next time, though.
May I look for your tune for 5 minutes there, though. Yeah, tell you, we are trying to find something to squeeze right now. Was it me? Thank you very much, Baz. No, all right, cool.
Yes, this is Buzzin' B here. taking over from Freddie Melody. And my show will be dedicated to Brother Ducky today. So I'm going to start off with a couple of tracks, and then I'm going to get right into it. So Freddie Melody, I just want to thank you for not just blazing the trail and opening the door for me, that I can have a good show.
No, me thank you. For extra.
For the extra time. 10 minutes now, you
10
know.
10 minutes. They want to charge me, though. Yeah. I will understand, too. Yes.
No, I will send you the invoice. Don't worry about it.
All right, Buzzy B. Thanks. Thanks a million, yeah?
All right. Hey, my brother. You're doing a phenomenal job. I should have been with you this evening, and we have planned it to be so. But as you know, I'll be your virtual presenter along the way, and I'm with you in spirit. Thank you for what you're doing. Listeners, it's not easy for you to host a show when you're so close to the person. For us as presenters, as people who work in the media, it is very challenging because it's a very personal. So I'll say to you, big yourself up, and a round of applause to you.
Yeah.
I'd like to take the opportunity to thank SLR management. You guys are doing a phenomenal thing for giving us this platform. We know you also are grieving as well, so we give you thanks. Mm-hmm. And most importantly, I'd like to big up the family, to the Queen herself, Mrs. Williams. Mummy Williams, we love you. I had the opportunity to meet you some time back with our brother Dougie, and to his brothers and family and siblings and sisters, we appreciate you. Mummy, thank you for letting us share in your son's life. We love you, and you know that we are with you throughout.
Yes.
Greetings, my brother. Yes, blessed love to you,
Dougie B. Yes. And before you go, Flower, I know that you did work with Dougie. What was it? Can you share your experience with us briefly?
Well, to be truthful to you, I can't think of a word to sum it up right now, because it was one that was full of love, full of admiration. Brother Dougie, as what he always says, I want to piggyback. And I think that will make a lot of sense to many of us. I want to piggyback with that, what you just said there, what you said earlier about his admiration, his dedication to the community. It's phenomenal. And many of you might know that I was a part of the media world and retired some time back. Sometime when I was hosting the show MTV, BBS show, along with my co-host, Lavina Brown. And also when I was doing various radio shows, again, big up Millennium Supreme, and we had a program there. So both radio and television, I had the opportunity to work with Brother Dougie.
Yes, that was Flower there, giving her contribution there about her experience with Brother Dougie and what it meant to us. I'm just going to open greetings.
Greetings. This is what you call live.
I do apologize.
You call live. You know, my brother, what I want to say to you, again, you said something about his smile. This evening, it was very challenging for me also. But when I closed my eyes, when I thought about my brother's infectious smile that he had, Dr. Douglas, I knew that I just had to get the strength somewhere to be able to be a part of what you're doing here this evening.
Yes, that smile was an enigmatic smile. I would always say, anytime there's a power cut, we have to find Dougie. Because that would light up not only the UK, but the world. He was pretty much known for that smile.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I had the opportunity to meet him. A wonderful woman who's gone back to our ancestors at the moment, Dr. Sandra Hurst.
Mm-hmm.
Many of you might be aware of of this woman. She was obviously very well known, very dedicated, a financial expert, and she was the one who introduced me to Brother Dougie. So that's from then we started to work together and so forth. And he was very, he would always be a part of our BBS show on Ben TV. He was someone who was forever fighting campaigns. Again, I want to piggyback earlier on that amazing interview that you had with Amani, that he was speaking about the paddy, about the bookie shop. And we had him on at that time as well. So not only was he there as a specialist in relationship as well as finance, but he now that the then team, I know, like, for example, I spoke to Lavina earlier, and she's also grieving, but we're giving thanks to know him as well. And, I think I need to mention a few quick names who's a part of the team, because I know they're grieving as well. Ushe, Brother Tony, and of course, not even forgetting the man himself who spoke TV, Dr. Alistair Soyede, will remember Dougie with a lot of admiration as well. And okay. Most importantly, go ahead, let me just hear what you're saying.
No, you go ahead, because, yep.
Yeah, I also want to say that I spoke to Ras Daniel Babu, who is an expert when it comes on to health practitioner, and he actually resides in Japan. And when he heard about what had happened to Brother Dougie, he was also shaken. This is a man who phenomenally will come to the UK and give advice and support to us as people of color, as women.
I think we're having a little bit of challenge there with Flower. Left off. It was really just speaks to the way that Brother Dougie was. Yes, just sorting out some technical issues there that we were having as it goes. Yes, we've got brother leader Ben Dak on the line, and he's going to be sharing his contribution. Good evening, Ben Dak.
Tendai greetings, my brother. Can I just bring greetings in the most precious, powerful, and bountiful name of our motherland, our Kibbalah, Mama Africa, to the sacred spirits of our most gracious ancestors, and in a prayer for oneness, hope, and prosperity for all our people on the face of Mother Earth. Tendai Mwari.
Yes, we just want you to, I know you're from the Kibbalah movement, and you've known Brother Dougie for a very long time. I just want you to share your thoughts, you know, and your experience of Brother Dougie.
Yes, Tendai Mwari, it's an honor to be invited to do so, Brother Buzzy B. Let me just first of all convey my deepest condolence on behalf of the Al Kibbalah Revivalist Movement to the family of Brother Dougie for their loss of their son, their sibling, and whatever other relatives he has in his family. I want to also give thanks and praises unto Mwari Nyakusika, God the creator of the universe, through Mazima Mukuru, our great ancestors, for blessing us with Brother Dougie. We bless and celebrate the womb of his mother and the loins of his father, through which he was conveyed to us in this earthly dimension of the cycle of life. Brother Dougie, as you know, Brother Buzzy B, is a brother that was very well known, very popular, because of the, first of all, the kind of person he was. Very kind-hearted, friendly individual, a brother who loved people, loved the company of people, a brother who was very good-humored, and all of that made him gave him a very attractive presence among us. I've known Brother Dougie since the early 80s. He was already on Liberation Road when I came into my consciousness. And we spent many, many hours at Head Start Sunday meeting. That's where we had our grounding and we attended almost every Sunday. We were there being educated, being informed and inspired by an array of erudite, conscious African presenters who would speak on African history, African culture, African spirituality, African common affairs. And that's where our learning began. Indeed, from there, we joined many campaigns, the Broadwater Farm campaign, the Brixton campaign, when we had those uprisings in the mid-1980s, and many demonstrations over the years. Brother Doogie was a close, was a supporter, staunch supporter of the Al-Kablan Revivalist Movement, especially in its early days, attending most of our meetings and ceremonies. And he was just all these a strong and awesome presence. When he was there, you felt his spirit. He had a voice that rang out from the gathering. You know, when he would give you a response approvingly to the power of the word, you know, which is something like power talk. And just his presence was very inspiring and very uplifting. So we, within the Al-Kablan Revivalist Movement, we were shocked to hear of our brother's passing. We are deeply moved by the fact that our brother is no longer with us in the physical. But we also know from the wisdom of Mudimu Makuru, our great ancestors, that our brother still lives on in the spirit, that we have his legacy that we can celebrate. We have the memory of his character, his gregarious, his character, that, you know, all of us love so much. There's so much to remember about our beloved brother Doogie. Fond memories, even as we feel pain and hurt at the loss. There's so much fond memories that we have that we can share with each other to cheer each other up as we try to readjust and as we try to move forward without this very valuable individual in our community.
Yes.
Of course, he was a presenter on SLR. We know he also organized health seminars in our community. We know Brother Doogie years ago used to sell, for many years, one of the first sellers, as I can remember, one of the first people to sell a range of black art to the community. And you know, he's going to be missed on so many levels. So many organizations would have valued Brother Doogie's support, because he was just everywhere. You know, Brother Doogie would support a range of initiatives in our community. Just about everywhere that I went over the years, Brother Doogie was there rendering his support
his service
to a number of different organizations.
Yeah, so selflessly, you know, Brother Lego Bandaka, you know, it's been, your words are just as moving as everybody else's, but it is so difficult to, even for myself, who is a man of words, to find words to really describe the level of commitment that Doogie gave for his community. You know, every sinew, you know, of his energy, of his body, he gave it for the community, because he really wanted to see black and African people really rise to be at their best potential. And I think that's why he branched off into so many different areas: health, wealth, finance, you know, relationship, because he wanted that balance, because you know that it could only be at its apex if all those areas were dealt with.
You know, as Tendai Murari, I totally agree with you, Brother Buzzidi. And you know, as someone who, as I said, I've known Brother Doogie for many years, and spent, especially in the 80s and the 90s, we spent a lot of time together, many hours together. In fact, oftentimes when we would leave a public meeting, we would end up on the street just reasoning with each other, reasoning on the topic of discussion, and we would go on for hours, and sometimes we would end up at somebody's home And when we ended up at that person's home, we would sometimes sit down and reason all night till the morning. You know, and that is a measure of the passion that we felt, the profound commitment that we felt to the liberation of our people, and the search for answers, for the way to, or the right answer to lift our people up and empower our people so that we can liberate ourselves. Brother Dugi was passionate about his people's liberation. He loved his people. He loved his African culture. He loved his African history. And he was deeply, deeply committed. And, you know, he is, he's a great loss to our community.
Yes, it is. Brother Leader Brandak, I just want to thank you for taking the time, because I know you've also got your own program going, and I just want to thank you for taking the time from your own radio program to contribute to this tribute this evening. I just want to thank you, Brother Leader Pandaka. Thank you for that.
Bless you, my brother. Give thanks and praises. Tendai Mori.
Yes, that was Brother Leader Pandaka from the Kabiland Revivalist Movement, who knew Dougie for quite some time. I just want to share some texts that have been coming in the studio. This is coming from Cosmic. He says, "That's right, Brother Dougie helped to stop the influx of betting shops in black areas such as Tottenham. We have lost a great pan-Akabulan activist." Coming from Principal Danite, I'm saying, "I'm so sorry to say condolences to the family, and that has left us. Amen and amen. In Christ Jesus of Nazareth, mighty enough love." That's coming from Principal Danite. We just having some information also coming to the studio. We just the lines are pretty much open, so you can pretty much start to send to get your contributions in and studio, because today we are celebrating and commemorating the life of Brother Dougie. You have heard the tributes so far of the kind of man he was, a man who dedicated his life to that. I'm going to take this call. SLR Radio, good evening.
Oh, good evening, Buzzing Bee. Hello, it's Star.
Yes, Star, good evening. How are you this evening?
Yes, I'm very well. I'm in good health, which is the most important thing. You know, friends and family are well, and just been really humbled by everything that's taking place on a global level, to be honest with you.
But obviously we are here to commemorate the life of a great man and a great loss to the community, Brother Dougie. We just want you to share your thoughts and, you know, and your feelings about Brother Dougie. Yeah, just go right ahead.
I would love to, but you know, before I do that, I just really want to say a big thank you to yourself and the station, everybody who's part and parcel of SLR, to take the time to put this together. I've been listening since the start of the show, and the truth of the matter is, I think people don't always realize how much, you know, the effort, what it takes to deliver something like this. But what's brilliant, the community has stood up, and you know, there's definitely a lot of grief and sadness around because of Brother Douglas's Brother Doug, as we call him, passing. But just listening to the tributes, I was thinking, this one person, just the caller before, was just literally reeling off. I'd counted maybe at least 10 different things. He said health, this, that, relationships, you know, all the things that Brother Dougie got involved with. And it seems kind of, not impossible, but because we know it, this is all the things that he participated. But it was clear he was actively involved with
Go ahead.
Okay. He was actively involved with a lot of community issues. He took them on. He didn't wait for the, you know, they talk about the, you know, he didn't take wait for something necessarily to start. He was out there pioneering things. But what I was thinking, one of the ways that we as a community, anyone that knew him, loved him, worked with him, past, present, future, I was thinking, all the work and effort that Brother Dougie's done, who's going to pick up those batons? So who's going to be the person to now run, carry on talking about prostate? Who's going to be the person to talk about mental health? Who's going to be the person to talk about relationships? Who's going to be the person to look at the elders? You know, all the work that Brother Dougie invested in, the community, he gave and gave and gave. It's now the perfect opportunity for us as community to actually step up and to participate and to get involved in community issues. Because a lot of us, we do not really get involved.
He went off in so many different areas because he knew that it could only be done, because if one area wasn't right, then it would unbalance the other side. So that's why he needed, that's why he knew that all of the areas had to be addressed, and he tried to do it all on his own. He threw everything at it, and I think he has to be admired for that, and how he did it.
No, definitely, total admiration for his for the contribution, without a shadow of a doubt. But now we have to look at us as a community, because when we talk about heritage, we talk about legacy. All these words, they're nice warm words and they sound all dominant and final, but the truth of the matter is, the heritage and the legacy, they're things that people have to create. So they're things that continue after, they go on and on and on. We now have an opportunity to create a legacy for Brother Dougie, because that legacy actually would apply to so many people. But it's crucial, it's absolutely crucial, we all do a little bit of introspection and see, you know, where we can add the value to our community and step up, step into the frame, you know, really go out, look after our elders, you know, our young people. You know, I think the first caller, Flower, was talking about the parenting, all the work that Brother Dougie's contribution has made. We have to look at who in our community is going to continue that work, because that's the real legacy. Who is going to step up and say, right, I'm going to do this now. No one's trying to imitate or create or mirror or clone Brother Dougie, because he is absolutely unique. That's not what I'm suggesting for one moment. What I'm saying is to acknowledge the effort and the work that was put in place, you know, by Brother Dougie, to honour that. If we as a community at all levels stepped up, took on the baton for something small, it doesn't have to be a major thing, but just kept that going, you know, so people know that his contribution, his effort, nothing's gone to waste.
Absolutely. I couldn't have put it much better myself, Star. As you know, that you've worked on a number of projects with him as well, including the flavor showcasing. Because he was not only a radio host, he was also a compere, an excellent one at that. So he worked on a number of the Speakers Club. He also compere there as well, and the flavor showcasing, which is the international talent thing. And you see the job that he did there in 2018, you know, because you were a talent judge at that particular
that's
event,
right.
You know,
that's
and it was all community based. Even though it was international, it was still appealing to the community. And Dougie did a sterling job every Saturday at Uptown Restaurant at the time, comparing with that, along with Chanel, who he co-hosted it with. But Dougie, I mean, the list. If I had to start one, the thing that Dougie connected him to, it would probably take me all day, and probably for the balance of the year. And but Star, you know, a lot of people wants to contribute their little bit.
Okay.
And I just want to thank you for taking the time out.
Thank you as well for the time.
Yeah.
We are paying tribute to Brother Dougie, but at the end of the show, I'd be very grateful if we could continue the tribute for Bernie Grant as well.
Absolutely. Tell us about that as well. Another great community person.
I know Dougie would be giving me 1 minute of Dougie's time. So on Wednesday, the 8th of April, this week actually, it's going to be 20 years that Bernie Grant passed away. Mm-hmm. And we are also, as a community, going to pay tribute to him. There was an event that was going to take place at the West Indian Cultural Centre, but due to the pandemic, and we all know that the current world situation, we've moved the event online. So we've got individuals playing tribute, sending in photos, telling their stories. JJ AIL TV has made a wonderful, an absolutely wonderful video documentary about Bernie Grant, and it's literally going to be hosted via Zoom. So as many people that want to give tribute, we really encourage people to do that. We've got people dedicated poems, all sorts of things that our community, you know, there's a lot of pain in our community because we've had one thing after the other, you know, and the pain doesn't appear to disappear. It seems like it's never going to end.
Okay, I just want to thank you.
People are going to share.
Yeah, thank you, Star, for
well
that.
Well done, we're celebrating. Great show. Yeah, keep it up.
Thank you very much. We're celebrating two great men in the community.
We are, definitely.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, that was Star, who presented the 100% partial, as well as myself. Now on to bigger and better things, doing the 4U2 magazine. If you've seen that out there, then that is it. Let's take this call. Hello, good evening. Global Horizon SLR Radio. Hello, good evening.
Hi there.
Yeah, good evening.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Loud and clearly. Hi there, James. Or Buzzing B.
Yeah, how are you doing?
Very well, thank you. Hesketh Benoit.
Yeah, I can hear you, Hesketh. It's sorry that we are not speaking on the good or positive things, I suppose you can call it, but nevertheless, we are here to celebrate the life of the late, great Brother Dougie, Douglas Williams. You know, so I just want you to just share your thoughts and your feelings about Brother Dougie.
Yeah, I just want to say that first and foremost, give thanks to the family that's still with us in this domain. That, you know, we had time, the people that have spoken about Dougie and his family, that we've had time with Dougie due to his mum and his dad that birthed him. So big up for that.
Hesketh, can you, I think you've gone a little bit faint. Are you speaking into the phone? You've gone a little bit faint there.
Yeah, and the funny thing is, I've just done some deliveries to some of our pensioners in the community, and Dougie helped set that up. 100 deliveries got out today for various people that can't move because of this disaster that's hit our land. But I really do want to contribute in regards to bigging up Dougie, because I've known Dougie for probably over 40 years, maybe, you know, in regards to his movements. As a community activist, we first got to know each other as far back, I believe, by Cable Lam was saying, he was the poster man. You could get any. His activism started from there, always being, I would say, love his music. As you quite rightly said, and some of the other people spoke, he had several things that he could do fantastically. But what I call Dougie, in terms of when he started doing his events, he mobilized our people under a roof where he put on health, wealth, prosperity, you name it. He could get the speakers to the venues. I big him up for, because several times I said I would take on when his host, Dr. Africa, came over. He brought Dr. Africa over and he said, yes, I need a driver. I said, Dougie, no problem, anytime. And I got Dr. Africa with his wisdom going around and talking to people about how, as black people, we can heal ourselves without taking these drugs. But Dougie just was so inspirational. I knew Dougie, every time we spoke, we had lots to speak about the community, because as people know, you know, as someone that's very community focused, you know, every time we met, we'll be setting up a plan out. Our last plan that we had, and many people didn't know, Dougie, facilitated Men With Voices with me, and then we went on to do Mind, the mental health program, for several. We did three blocks of 12 weeks for the Mind program.
Yeah, but you also
men on board.
Yeah, I tried to cut you, but you also did a program with is it Men With Voices as well?
Men With Voices. That's fantastic. That was looking at getting all the men together. Not so that we did get predominantly 80% black men. It was mature men over the age of 30, but we've got some under 30. And this program was so fantastic that we got the men talking about their issues within the community, you know, and lifted them, because it was a 12-week program. We ran one at Northumberland Park, which was very successful. Then we got some more fun into one, run one at Broadwater Farm. And we're looking, well, obviously, that he was the main man in regard to facilitation for the program. And we did have guest facilitators. But Dougie's, you know, when you flex with him, the vibe that's created with Dougie, second to none. Mm. As lots of our people say, you know, he just vibe with you, and it's all action stations. And I'm hoping that's what he delivered to people that he worked with. And I hope that, as Sister Star just said, you know, people take that on board and don't forget it, and use it properly in a righteous way, so that we can grow our community and his legacy there stays alive for our people. Mm. Once we're doing our program, it could be one-to-one, could be a crowd, could be, you know, loads of people. But once we think of Brother Dougie, he will give us that strength. He will give us that power.
That's it.
To deliver our program.
That's it.
You know? Yeah. So I'm very honored and very proud to know, but very, you know, upset that early life taken away from our community. His visions for setting up, you know, things within the community was gone. You know, so taken away far too young, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, way too young. Way too young. You know, as I was saying to Brother Leader Bindaka and also Star, because you can hear the tributes that are coming in to see you. Just tells you about the magnitude of the man that he was.
Yes. Yeah. You know. You know, man full of, you know. I know I'm not necessarily going to repeat some of these very important words. I've been listening to the show from the very beginning, and people have given so much honor, so much grace to that man Dougie, but without him, certain things wouldn't be happening.
I'm telling you.
I'm going to celebrate Bernie Grant, but people with vibration within our community don't have to be MPs. They don't have to be big politicians. They don't have to have loads of money and wealth.
Yeah,
they come along in different guises, and Dougie took that.
Yeah, because I agree with you, because one of the defining moments for me in seeing Dougie, and it was many of them, in seeing the leadership in Dougie, was when he was leading the campaign against Paddy Power.
I remember that one.
And that's when he asked me to come in, and I came in, and I supported him in whichever way, and you were part of the campaign as well.
He won that campaign.
Yes.
And when Dougie came to me with that campaign, I said, listen, man, you're taking on Paddy Power. This is a big corporation with lots of outlets, and you're taking them on. But he took them on and fight them down.
Yes.
Because I was lecturing at Cornell at the time. Like, he said to me, you're going to mobilize, get some students down, you come down. And when he first told me, I just thought, you know, it's like a corner shop trying to do their thing, and that's going to stop. Like, he said, no, they're not going to happen. Not in Tottenham. Not on his watch. I believe that's the word he used. Not on my watch. I'm going to fight this one because we have far too many off licenses and
betting shops and so,
gambling places in Tottenham,
it.
You know?
Yeah.
And I said, wow. I said, all right. Because, you know, in the college, I've fought campaigns before in regards to union and conditions. But when Dougie took this, I thought to myself, I'm going to run with him. But is he going to run all the way? And he ran all the way and back.
Yeah, and he did. And at first, I said to Dougie, well, this is a big one. You know, and even I had my little doubts, you know, creeping in because of the corporate body, you know, the corporate strength of Paddy Power. But Dougie had that belief, you know, and in the end,
that's fantastic, because That when we did that campaign, I remember you being there, James. I thought, geez. I said, that gave me a shock. I said, well, if we can mobilize these people, do the questionnaires, and be there on that corner for loads of weeks we were there saying, yeah. Not on that watch, man, you know?
Yeah, because we
so
were...
proud when
yeah,
I went there, you know?
Yeah, because we were there on Seven Sisters in the corner there. We were winter. Yeah. Even one day, I remember it was freezing minus, and we were still there campaigning.
That's it, some bitter winters there, man. Bitter winters. Not like even
bitter
now,
winters,
you know what I'm
yes. Yes.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Anyway, Heskiff, as you can imagine, lots of people want to give their contribution, and I want to thank
man,
you
I
for
respect to that.
Yeah, for taking the time.
And I take my hat off to you, what you're doing today, because it's very important. We must celebrate our powerful people, Stuggy was. I take my hat off to the management at SLR for being there, thick and thin. His shows on a Tuesday was so inspiring. And several times I came down to the studio, and he knows that, you know, what I'm doing as a sportsman, as a motivator within the bar of Haringey. And it's just fantastic to share the mic with him and reasoning at all levels. You know, when he put me to say, events man, you know, motivator, personal development. He's the one that, when I went over to the Docklands there, to see Les Brown, I went with him. Mm. We got some tickets, we went there. And it's fantastic, and that lifted me up. So, you know, hats off to Doug, and I say his spirit is with us because we believe in the spirit world. And everyone that moves, think of Dougie. Big up brother Dougie, who is live and his spirit still. Big up, I say.
Yeah, thank you
so much.
Yeah, thank you so much, Heskiff Benoit, for your contribution this evening.
Yeah. One thing before I leave, I do want to say we'll push on that Bernie Grant show because all our leaders are very important. I'm going to hopefully get on that Zoom thing, which is obviously, you know, the technology, but I'll get on that. But one thing I do want to say about Dougie, man travel east, north, east, west, south of London. Many times I'll pick him up, drop him off. I'm saying, what are you doing, Dougie? I'm Haringey, but you're traveling everywhere, man. Everywhere we go, Dougie just known, you know what I'm saying? Unbelievable. So he was a traveller, always spreading the good word, and I must say, for the youngsters living, listening now, we want youngsters to pick up the baton and keep up the program, because at the end of the day, Dougie's show should not be lost.
Mm.
But, you know, a young person should say, right, you know, step into that field, or someone's got several, but I'd like it to be young, give the longevity there, and we have to get our apprentices picking up for us, because when we go, someone's got to step into that place.
Yes. Oh, thank you very much,
Heskiff. Thank you very much, brother. You know what I mean? I'm just feeling so emotional now. As you know, we could go on forever talking about Dougie, man.
Yes.
We could go on forever because...
Yes,
but,
definitely.
You know, thank you very much for giving me that window. I appreciate that. And I big yourself, I big Dougie up. And let's keep on moving, keep on going strong.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Heskiff, for that contribution.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was Heskiff Benoit there, who spent many years in education and also sports and community development through sports and health, and he himself has worked with things. Let's take this call. Hello, good evening. Global Horizons, we are paying a tribute to Dougie this evening. Good evening.
Hello, good evening.
Yeah, good evening.
Hi, family. How are you?
I am great.
Oh, brilliant. This is Zulema.
Yeah, I can see Zulema. How are you this evening, Zulema?
I'm fine, Buzzy B. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm under the circumstances that, you know, doing this tribute for Brother Dougie is not an easy one. But from all the love and the tributes I'm hearing, that is also helping me through the program.
Yes, well, what can I say? I feel that we have lost our hero.
Zulema, I can hear some feedback there. Have you got the radio on?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you turn it down, please? I can hear some feedback. Thank you.
What a hero in our community he was.
Mm-hmm.
And he held up all our shoulders. He was always there for you, Douglas. He always had a smile, that smile. Was amazing. He was magical. he drew you in. He was a magnet to the community. He had such a light. I just feel so lost without him. I think about him every day. I remember always saying to Douglas, Douglas, I love you. From a woman to a man, I just love you. And he would always shy away and just smile. Give you that beaming, beaming, beaming smile. There's only one. But hopefully, hopefully through this, there will be more warriors to come. More warriors to take on the baton.
At this point in the story,
I really, really hope now our brothers and our sisters come forward and keep on this legacy that Douglas has started. I remember when you went to this black market, as they call it, for us to give and exchange our own money from each other. And when you went into the centres where Doug is on the event, oh my goodness, you just felt so much love, so much gratitude that you were alive to be there and experience it. See our people making money, their own money. See how creative we are. See all the designers, see all the bookmakers, see all the people that sold food and kept us going for the, you know, whilst we were there. Dougie, he was a great organizer and we all loved him. And one thing I always remember, and I have to smile now, he loved the music. Money is coming to me. I always used to remember that, that motivation music that he always did. Money is coming to me. And also, thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. I always remember those two songs that represent Dougie's radio section and show. And also, the fact that I only spoke to him Friday before. He phoned me, we had a long conversation, we had a laugh as usual. And he says, take care, my sister. And I said, take care, Doug. Always love you, the usual. And then the Monday, when I got the news, I couldn't do anything for the whole day. And I'm still walking in limbo, expecting to see him. Because you know, sometimes just seeing about. And that. So the other time that I just saw him was the last time they had the event in Park St. Anne's Road.
Yeah, Chestnut
and,
Centre.
We came off the bus and there was Dougie and we walked together to the event. Wow, what a special, special man. Community, let's not forget him.
Yeah.
Let's not forget his legacy.
Yeah.
And also condolence to the family. I would love to know how the family are doing. If anybody knows, can they let us know, please? Because we just want to know that Douglas' mother and family are okay, because he made sure that we were okay.
Yeah.
That's my contribution. Douglas, we love you, we salute you. One love, and I know the ancestors have embraced you. And anytime you want to talk to me spiritually, I'm here.
Yes, thank you, Sister Azuluma, for that heartfelt contribution there. You can see the love that was there for. But let's take this call. Hello, good evening. I'm Global Horizon on SLR Radio. We are paying a special tribute to the late great Brother Dougie. Hello, good evening.
Hello, good evening.
Yes,
this is Andy Advocate.
Andy Advocate. Oh yes, Andy Advocate. My co-host. How are you? How are you this evening?
I'll just thank you for doing a great job and a great show this evening.
Yes. We are doing it on the behalf, you know, because I had taken the time off, but I decided that, you know, Brother Dougie is really worth it, and you know, I thought that you know, there were people even telling me that I should cancel the show, and I spoke to management, and I said, okay, how can we make sure that it's safe for me to come in, and we worked that out, and I'm here because I had to do it for my dear brother. So what are the thoughts that you want to share about Brother Dougie this evening?
Well, Dougie, well, my first to say condolences to his family, and we've lost a great leader, a leader that's provided a platform called Find Your Voice, and he did make me find my voice over many, many years ago. And as we heard already, that we was involved in the betting shop. Mm. And he had me on the road with him doing a few questionnaires and so forth. And I suppose that's when I started to get really, really involved in the community work of being a community activist. We grew to be friends in the end, becoming very close friends. And many times I would drop him home, and we would sit in the car and we'd be reasoning for nearly an hour, as one of your previous callers had mentioned. He loved to reason, you know, very warm-hearted person, you know, believed in, you know, self-reliance, you know, we can do it for ourselves, you know. Mm. You know, and he sort of, you know, and from then, you know, the other things that he was doing, especially about the health and about prostate, you know, it was him that showed me that there was two type of tests. There's two type, and then the second one that people afraid from, but we have to go and do it. And along with him and Dr. Vasco Stevens helped to promote that. Mm. Yeah, he was very much into the health, and he loved that. He loved that African culture.
Mm.
He loved that, and you know, he used to wear all those nice African clothing. I don't know where he used to get them from, but he used to look really sharp in those African clothing that he was in.
Mm.
But as I said, he also became close to a group that I'm involved in for many, many years, the Black Arts Production Theatre, Bat Theatre.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and he used to come to our events and give his feedback on what he saw, and one thing he did love the children that were performing, and the work that was coming from the actors, you know, especially when we was doing Bring Back the Love, you know. Yeah, he loved the acting. He really, you know, had much praises for the work that my brother Richard Reed was doing, and the teaching that he was giving them to develop that craft. Yeah, he loved that. Mm-hmm. And he's going to be a great loss.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Dougie obviously shared a certain kind of the energy that he brought to the proceedings. What was quite difficult to interpret, you know. So he had this aura and this energy that when, you know, that he brought to anything, and. I remember one time he was hosting an event to do with Bring Back the Love with Menelik Shabazz, you know, a filmmaker, and he asked me to be on the panel, and I said to him, well, I don't know anything about relationships and all that sort of thing and love and that, you know, and Dougie said to me to don't worry about it, you just say what you know, and you will gain strength from the rest at a panel. And I thought, and after that I thought to myself, wow, that really, because I'm confident in other areas, but but I admit that I wasn't confident in that area. And he said, no, don't worry about it, you can do it. And from there on my confidence grew in that area, and I said to myself, and he tapped me on the shoulder and I said, that is a sign of a good leader.
Of
someone who can inspire you, as you know, and motivate you as well. So, in that, I learned so many things from Dougie in that respect.
Yeah, he was a great motivator,
mm-hmm.
and he brought us together in a way that other people didn't.
And other people couldn't, I think, because I think he had that little nut and that aura and that energy that he was able to. It didn't really matter who.
And you know, one of the things that I loved about him, he was always give you a chance to listen. You know,
he was a good listener. He was a good, very good listener.
You know, he will give you that. You know,
like Star said, and we gotta, you know, to remember him in an honorable way, his legacy in the way that he would be proud.
Yeah, and yeah, and also I have to, you know, give him personal thanks for the support that I had when I was running my the local elections in May 2018.
Because I remember because I was your campaign manager. I'm just letting that out. I remember Dougie was also at the launch. Yes.
Yeah,
because he came there to support your efforts.
Yeah, and you know the community issues, he was concerned about it, and you know, and any way that he can spread knowledge to our people, you know, he told us to stand up and fight back, but not with fists, but with knowledge.
That's it, and strategy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah,
with knowledge, you know, is the key thing for him, and then the self-reliance. Mm. You know.
Yes.
You know, so yeah, he really opened my eyes to a lot of things, a lot of way of doing things, and yes, he sort of helped mentor me to where I am today. Mm. You know, so well, I'm going to give thanks. And he said his favorite word, give thanks.
Yeah, that was his favorite phrase, give thanks. Yes, right. So, Andy Advocate, I know that you couldn't have been in the studio here to share the program with me, given the circumstances that we're in, but I just want to thank you for calling in and giving your contribution to the late, great Douglas Williams. I just want to thank you.
That was a pleasure and an honor. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, that was Andy Advocate, who normally co-hosts with me here on the on Global Horizons. You know, we are, honouring a very great man. So, unless we're going to take another call, we have Supreme on the line. Hello, good evening.
Greetings. Can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear.
Am I coming over okay? Yeah.
You're coming over quite clearly. So go right ahead.
Well. I'm really in a bit of a state over hearing my brother Dougie.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't even know where to start.
Supreme, can you speak up a bit?
Okay, hold on. Hello, can you hear me now?
Yeah, that is much better.
Yeah, apologies for that.
Yeah, no problem
at all. Yeah, you're running the tribute program to Brother Dougie.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to come in with how he actually came onto SLR Radio.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to come in from that point because I know you've got a lot of people phoning in. Well, basically, Dougie was doing, obviously, he was doing Find Your Voice before he came on radio, yeah? And Find Your Voice was doing events in the city. I was working at a shop on West Green Road, number 126 West Green Road, and it was a carpentry wood shop. Dougie would pass by the shop and leave his flyers, and he would say, "Oh, could you read that out on the radio?" Now, I just want to let listeners know, originally, I'm an SLR radio DJ from late 80s, and I done a radio show in the exact spot that Dougie does on the Tuesday. My slot was 10 till 12. Dougie came past the shop, he gave me a flyer about one of his events. I looked at the flyer. He goes, "Can I read it out?" I said, "Yeah, I'll read it out." I read it out, looked on the flyer, and I said, "Yeah, it looks interesting." And I invited him to come on SLR, right? And he came on SLR with a gentleman named John Edwards, who I think is going to ring, possibly if he gets a chance to ring in. So they were doing an event, Central London.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't had a clue because it's the first time I've been to a Find Your Voice event.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So, the Sunday, I was in Peckham, going to watch a black movie, short movie makers, and I said to myself, let me pop into this event that this brother was talking about on the way back. And this was near Shoreditch, near Night Moves, kind of just before London Bridge.
Uh-huh.
Dougie had his event. This is an event he was doing.
Mm-hmm.
So I popped in there, and I was like, wow, this is totally different, you know. And my experience was that this was my first, how can I say, to what they call public speaking and personal development.
Mm-hmm.
And Dougie was hosting it, and obviously the same gentleman I spoke about who was on the flyer, they were both in there, they got up, they spoke, it was inspiring, it was educational, it was all the things that I've never seen before.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, wow, is this what Find Your Voice is about? So anyway, went home, weeks gone by, Dougie's passed by the shop, he's given me another flyer. So I said, Dougie, why don't you come on the radio and do a show? Because I said, the people at your event, they're fantastic. And he went, nah, he can't do radio. I said, no, I'll give it a try. So he goes, okay then. So he actually came in and done a show with John, and that was around relationships, right? And he kind of enjoyed it because he's in his element. But he didn't realize that radio at the time was another arm to what he was doing. So the following week on SLR, Tuesday, 10 o'clock, he turned around to me and said, yeah, man, I want to come back. So I said, no problem. So I said, I'll tell you what, Daddy, this is your show. I'm resigning. Hello, are you still there? Hello? Yeah, because I'm hearing a lot of... Sorry. So, following week, Dougie came back. SLR. He came with three people, right? This was the beginning of Find Your Voice. He came with Darren Beppo, the late Sandra Hurst, and Patricia Mills. Yeah? And again, when they done the show, it was new to me, this concept that he was doing, because they were educating people and informing people of, you know, Darren was health, Sandra was finance, and Patricia Mills was herself was into network marketing. So this was the kind of format when he came. This is what he came with. And before he came on radio to do that slot, they would meet up. They would meet up and prepare their show. Anyway, 2-3 weeks went by, and I'm going to give you a joke. Cowboy hadn't met Dougie yet from SLR, because I was kind of in... When Cowboy met Dougie, it was like a reunion. He goes, well, I'm brethren. I said, yeah. They met each other in Jamaica and whatever, and the synergy was there. So I just said to Cowboy, look, you know, you want to do a talk show, Dougie's there. He's the man, right? So from that, he started to do, you know, the Find Your Voice. But the main three people were those three people that he actually brought on the radio that kind of developed the style of show that he had today. And one thing I've got to say, it's been over 15 years, and I doubt if Dougie's missed a show. I doubt he's as if he's missed a show, right? And in that time of him doing the show, he has bought some ambassadors, he's bought some educators, he's done shows with celebrities, he brought them all on SLR, right? Mm. There are shows, but I haven't got enough time that I could say were quite memorable. And one of the shows I remember, which I thought he'd done an excellent show, was, you remember Felix Dexter, the comedian?
Yes, I do. Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he came on Dougie's show, and they had a show. That show was one of the ones I said, Dougie, wow. Also, when he interviewed Victor Romare Evans.
Yes, as well.
Mm-hmm. I was well impressed.
Yes.
You know? Hello?
Yeah, I can. I'm here.
Yeah, there were quite a few. I've got a list of people. Queen of Thua.
Yeah, go ahead.
Amina Matthews. Mm-hmm. This young lady won Black Girls Rock in the USA.
Mm-hmm.
And these were people that I never knew until Dougie brought them on. And he actually, from doing his radio show, started to do more local events with Find Your Voice.
Absolutely.
Because he told me, this is what he told me, Find Your Voice was about personal development and public speaking, and he was more focused on the city, and he started to bring it in. And as you know, he's done quite a few events at Parkview Academy, and to me, he's the one that's put that venue on the map. Issues. So if there was a current issue, Dougie would go, okay, get panels together, the panelists, and they would, as you know, the format was panel, outside were the stalls. Now to me, I thought, brilliant marketing. I didn't know nothing about African, Pan-Africanist stall holders and stuff, but he actually had this fantastic way of bringing all these people to sell their goods at an event while there was an event happening. And I was like, wow, this is, you know, marketing. How can I explain? Some people go to school and learn certain things. Dougie just done it. Mm. Yeah. He done, as I said, quite a few events which were local. He done quite a few events with people who were doing network marketing. I don't know if anybody's heard of Johnny Winborn.
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard of Johnny Winborn?
No, I haven't.
Yeah, what is Johnny Winborn is an American public speaker, and I never heard of him. But he's in the league of Les Brown. Woodbury Down, Dougie put on an event. He had Johnny Winborn there.
Yeah.
This guy was the one, like a young number one personal development.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just amazed that Dougie has the skill to find these people and put on an event.
Absolutely. So Supreme, I just want to thank you because as you can imagine, there are lots of people who want to give their contribution. But I just want to so thank you, appreciate that you give the listeners a history into how Dougie got on SLR, because you know that the SLR, that he used it as his platform to all his events, and you actually, you know, kind of told him that this is a way into your events and to what you're doing. This is a way in to connect into your community. And of course, he heeded your word, and the rest is history.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's an emotional time for me concerning Dougie. And I've got someone who has actually passed away
as well. Condolences, yes. Because you also lost your father as well, so
before Dougie passed, me and Dougie were actually talking about Dr. Layla Africa, Jammers.
Yeah.
My father, who passed away.
Please, well, the condolences.
There was quite a few things that me and him were talking about.
Mm.
So when I heard the news, because I was talking to him Sunday, I think it was Sunday night at 9 o'clock. And people were calling me. I said, no. I was talking to him. I was just talking to him. So I literally had to go to the house and find out. And I was in a bit of an emotional state.
Yeah.
But anyway, I want to thank you. And I'm hoping that we've got more contributions. Maybe next time I can concise how... because there's quite a lot that me and Dougie have done together and that he has done with the community, and I have most of that stuff on recorded, because we recorded quite a few of his events that he did do. So, look, moving after, looking, one of the proposals that I wanted to put is to start up the Find Your Voice Foundation, and that will continue the works of
Brother
Dougie Dove.
Yeah.
Where we'll be looking at the aims and ambition, aims and objectives, so that when we put them down, that even whoever's part of this organization, it will stick to what Find Your Voice was about.
Yeah.
So at the moment, it's just about putting, putting together how we saw or seen how Find Your Voice worked with Brother Dougie, and so that we can stick to that same format.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I've had plenty of meetings with him, so I kind of know Find Your Voice. And not only that, I would say to all those people that took your time and invested your time to go to Brother Dougie's event, I salute you. You know what Brother Dougie was about. So when the time is more settled, you yourself, all the listeners, all the people that used to go to Find Your Voice, we're going to sit down, we're going to talk, because this brother is a champion, you know. So I'm going to leave it there so that you can let other panelists, guests, to call in,
okay. Thank you, Supreme, there, for sharing that history,
and the
genesis of how Find Your Voice started as a radio program. So, Supreme, I salute you, and I want to thank you, and I do appreciate your contribution.
Thank
you, very much. There, that was Supreme sharing his thoughts, you know, and giving a little history about how it all started. There are lots of texts coming in the studio. I just want to share a text coming from Ray Diamond, who did a youth program, as I remember, with Brother Dougie. And she's saying that Brother Douglas provided many opportunities and platforms for myself and many others to shine. He has supported me, encouraged me, and reminded me of worth since the day I met him. Caller, can you hold on? Caller, can you hold on, please? Can you hold the line, please?
Thank you.
I'm reading a text. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Continuing, Weird Diamond text. He says that that he encouraged me and reminded me of the worth since the day I met him. He said, we often shared meaningful conversations, and he would pick my brains on many areas of my profession. I have watched him dedicated his life to the community. He truly was one of the greatest veterans and warriors in our community. I feel blessed to have taken under his wing, so to speak. May King Douglas rest in eternal peace. And that is a tribute coming from Ray Diamond. We have here on the line, we have Vasco Stevenson. Hello, good evening. Welcome to SLR on Global Horizons. Hello, good evening. Vasco? Vasco, are you there? Right, I can't hear Vasco there, but I'm sure he will come on the line. Vasco, are you there? Vasco? Right. He's not there because I'm not hearing anything there from him. Hello, SLR Radio, good evening.
Yeah, quick contribution from Jeff Radio Ready.
Yes, go quite ahead. Is this Jason speaking?
I'll be quick because I know maybe Vasco. Jeff Radio Ready. Vasco might want to call back, yeah?
Right, just go go right ahead, Jason.
Yeah, condolences and sympathy to the family of Dougie Douglas Williams. And also, sorry to hear, Radio. It just amplified what he was about, really. And I one thing I learned from his health shows, you know, is about sugar. That's one thing that made me really, it was like a gift for me, like I gotta stop eating things with sugar in it, because it's like affect your immune system and things like that. Yeah, I enjoyed the health shows and the seminars and things like that. He used to link up with Dr. Lola, he passed because, was it a few weeks when Dougie's last show on a Tuesday? I think I was the last person to call him, and I tuned in late and I said to Dougie, "What about Lola Africa? He's passed. Didn't he talk about it?" He said, "Yeah, I did earlier on." I said, "Oh," and he said, "Well, why didn't you talk?" I said to him, "Why didn't you talk about it again? Because you know he's a big guy." He said, "Yeah, but I'm tired now. You know, I'm getting tired," and I could hear he was sad in his voice. He said, "The last thing he said to me is, I'm tired now, I gotta go." And that's the last thing he said. Right? And, yeah, but I just wanna quickly run through a few things that people he worked with. Levi Roots, used to also highlight a motivational speaker, Les Brown, Sandra Hurst, money person, or that guy with. He's into wheels and testimonies and things like that. There's a lot. I can't think of it right now. I don't have a list. I have to sit down and think about it. Right, a list. There's so many things. I used to work, do things with the doctor in the Enterprise building in Dalston. Yeah, host meetings there. And in West Green Centre.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, on West Green Road. There. Yes.
Yes, that talent organization, you know, the talent, I think used to host that as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What's it called? Mm-hmm. With the talent, local talent.
Yeah, I'm Flavor Showcasing. Yeah, Flavor Showcasing.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Used to be part of that. Mm-hmm. And you see so much young talent, it was just good. Plus, mm-hmm. used to host be the speaker for the theatre, little short plays and things like that. He was just there, always there for supporting his community. Mm. You know, I was gonna have a Earth Day party, but it didn't happen. I was gonna invite him, but look, he's not around anymore. It's like, wow. But I could tell it's like within a week of Dr. Lola Africa passing. You know, it's kind of strange in a way.
Mm.
It's just this weird.
Mm.
It's just weird because I last saw Dougie in a funeral as well, for another sister that was sort of in the community, well, she was in the community and doing things a long time, and he's there. That's the last time I saw him physically. That was like 4 or 3 weeks ago, and wow, look at that.
Yeah. Anyway, Jason, I just want to because there are lots of people. There are lots of people, as you could imagine, trying to get through to give a tribute. So I just want to thank you for taking the time to pay tribute and to share your thoughts about Peter Dougie. I just want to thank you. Yeah, that was Jason there, paying tributes to the late, great Dougie. I just want to read a text here from Shola. Shola from the Rebirth of the Griot. Shola, how are you doing? He said, we as a community have the opportunity to create a legacy for Brother Dougie, like the caller said, but all also ask ourselves, what can I do to create that legacy? That's coming from Brother Dougie. I'm from Brother, from Sola. I'm just going to take this call. That was Colonel T just making. Let's take this call. Hello, good evening, Global Horizons, SLR Radio. Good evening.
Hello?
Yeah, good evening.
Wasn't it?
Yes, go ahead. Is this Vasco?
No, this is Alvin.
Who?
Jammer's his friend. I met you a few weeks back. You know, an event Robert Dougie did.
All right, okay, so go right ahead. What's your contribution this evening?
My contribution is like, my condolences first going out to Brother Dougie and his family.
Yes.
I didn't really know Dougie that long. I met him at the event with yourself. I mean, I spoke with you quite lengthy as well.
I remember. Yes, I remember now. Yes, I do. Yeah.
Yeah, and I got a lift back with Noel.
Yes, yes, I remember. Oh, yes, I remember. Yes, that was in just last month. Yes, I do.
Yeah, it's probably one of the last events, one of the few last events that we did.
Yeah, I remember.
I kind of like how I grew to love them. I mean, the power, the aura of Brother Dougie, like, is really impacted on me in a big way. I didn't really know him, like I said, that long, but it feels like I've known him all my life, you know. And the tribute I paid to him is like, he was just very inspiring. He's an all-round man to me, and I learned so much from him, and I've taken a lot from him as well. I know it's difficult times. I feel what he's shown myself, and what he's shown to a lot of others, the impact he's had on everybody that he knows, everybody knows of him, you know, it's been tremendous. Mm-hmm. You know, he's going to be a tremendous loss. And as I said, I feel like I've known him all my life. The vibe that Doug, Brother Dougie sends and gives out to people. You know, as you said earlier callers, like he has no discrimination. He treats everybody the same.
Mm. Yeah, very much so. Yeah, I know you've because I remember the event, the last event that Brother Dougie had at the Chestnut Centre. We you know, very powerful event indeed, and the fact that you've met him for the short time, and he's had that impact shows the enormity of the kind of spirit and the aura that he had, you know. So me myself, I've known him for over 30 years, And what I've known of Dougie, he has never, in those years, he's remained the same person. Humble, you know, and he just wanted it. It wasn't even about him. It was about the community and what he could do for black and African people. And that was what I know of Dougie. So I'm not surprised that he had that impact on yourself.
Yeah, he did. And that event, that particular event, I mean, I saw I saw how powerful Dougie was, you know, the aura of him, and how, you know, how he people took to him, and people like, you know, basically the power of the man, the aura of the man was like, I was in awe myself, you know. I knew the great works he's done, and he's going to be sorely missed, because I know Brother Dougie through Jammers, and you know, this is how I've come along, and I mean, this is the power of the man, you know, sort of, you know, bringing, you know, myself, you know, to the likes of myself, because I'm like-minded, like Brother Dougie, and like yourself, my tribute to him, I know you got a lot of callers, it's just like, I salute Brother Dougie in every respect of life. It was good to know him as long as I've known him. You know, I feel like I've known him all my life, and it was a pleasure to know the man. Yeah. And I give thanks for the time and for the appreciation of being with him.
Yeah. So, Cora, I just want to thank you for taking the time to share your experience and the impact and that Dougie had you. And I'm glad that in that short space of time that Dougie has influenced you and impacted on you in that way. Such was the spirit of the man. I want to thank you for your contribution this evening.
Yeah, no problem, Basil. Give thanks every time, brother.
Yeah, thank you.
You're doing a lot of good work.
Yeah, much thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah, again, as you can see, I'm trying to get some of the callers. I'm trying to get some callers in. Yeah, another call again. Hello, good evening. Hello, good evening, Global Horizons SLR Radio.
Hi, good evening. I am so happy to get through.
Yeah, well, what's your name?
My name is Zina Banks.
Zina Banks. I met you at the Jamaican thing at the Jamaican High Commission some years ago.
Jamaica competition winner, yes.
Yeah, absolutely. And we actually spoke at the Jamaican High Commission some years ago. I remember.
I've been listening to all the tributes today, and I can say condolences to his family and his friends and all that.
Yes.
But I'm kind of the new school from UK Principal School.
Yes.
He's really a principal, I tell you. Even winning the competition that I won, I have to tell you, when it comes down to my stage performance and start working with bands, he was the artist who saw me on stage and said, Zina Banks, you ain't no PA artist. He took me under his belt that same night when he met me. As I said, I'm new school, so this was 2011.
Yes.
And he took me under his belt that night, and by the end of that month, we were doing a live band show, and we did it at the Ritzy with Sister Beloved and Andrew Slowly. As I said, we're the new school, because I know that everyone has such big history with UK Principal. I can take my phone up and call him any hours of night and say, oh, you know, say some man want me to do some music. What do you think? And he will give me all this advice that we really have, you know, lost a good brother, legend, friend, father, grandfather, uncle. Me can't tell you how it feels, because I know that the part that he plays around here in this community, me not seen no one else do it like that. As everyone has been saying, he is not for himself. He's like for everyone. You know, I know that not everyone is going to be able tonight to call. So I really feel it. I wanna talk for Jedi Roots, and I wanna talk for Binsky. I wanna talk for Lady J. I wanna talk for Angelique. Any. I don't know how one man can be in so many places at one time. He loses, he doesn't miss any event for anyone. Anyway, let me just tell you my story. You know, we did a lot of shows. We started in the pubs, in the clubs.
Uh-huh.
We did everything. And he's a teacher. He knows his music. He knows how to read and write music. And he knows the music business. And when I'm with the band, you know, people are like, not even me, you know, the music so good. And he's like, play in a C sharp, play, you know, and we're jumping on the stage and I'm learning all this. It made me start to even go and learn music on a level, because, you know, a lot of us around here do music and we are not, we don't know the knowledge. I started to teach myself to play the piano because of this man. And I said, you know what? I can't go on these big stages and don't know my C from my D from my E, you know. And he would come to my house, and I just want to say that man will never call my phone and don't say, how's your daughter, how's your son? And I would say, they're fine. And UK Principal says, he will say to me, I want you to tell Trillian that I said hello. He will not leave the phone and not hail up everyone in my family to the best of his ability. Buffalo, if Buffalo don't get a chance to talk tonight, I want to talk about Buffalo and Dickie and them, and he was the one who introduced me to them. So for people who now get to talk tonight, Zina Banks say, me know how to feel, and I can't tell you, our community is truly mourning really, really mourning right now. I don't know what I'm going to do when I need advice. And one last thing. He had plans for all of us. He had plans. If I was on the phone with him, the last time I spoke to him, I know for sure. You know, he's working out. He's doing this. He's got his record label. And he was just going to drag us along with him. And another thing that people don't know, he's made it. He made it. He actually made it. This, you don't know, he's on stage in Italy. He's on stage in France. He's on stage all over the world working. Big up Jashaka. Because Jashaka, you know, he's done a few albums with them for the last couple of years. People don't know this. People all over Europe are mad over UK Principal right now. I'm not even joking. He's one of them. He made it. Yeah, not because he's been this advocate for all of us around here. He actually made it. And I know that other people want to talk. So I just want to say, I know that UK Principal made it. And it was a privilege to meet someone with such a good heart. And he never have a bad thing to say. You just always have a good thing to teach you. You always call it to teach you something. Yes, he made it. And I'm so happy that I met someone who lived their life and done everything the way how he wanted it to be done. I have no regret for him. I wanted his family to know that we respect this man so much, and he did you proud. He done his family proud.
Yes.
You want the UK Principal pitch up on a wall down a brick stand somewhere. I don't know who now.
Yeah, all right.
big up SLR Radio yourself.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. Mrs. Banks, I know you've been. Yeah, thank you so much. You know, because I remember I met you at the Jamaican launch at the Jamaica High Commission when they were
the Jamaica High Commission. Yes.
Yeah, I was there. That's where I met you, and you, you know, and I could tell your energy and your vibes was always positive. But I'm glad that Dougie was able to have that kind of impact on your journey as well. But you know, I know we, the community, we're going to miss him. And we've got to find ways in which how to cope with it, because now we have to find coping mechanism. And I think the best way we can do that is to honor him and also to continue his legacy and the things that he believed in.
To call his name.
Yes, absolutely. So I thank you for your heartfelt and your emotional contribution this evening, Mrs. Banks. I just want to thank you.
Big up his family.
Yeah, big up. Thank you. Yeah, that was Mrs. Banks there, performer, who sharing their legacy. Let's take this call. Hello, good evening. Yeah, SLR James, Radio. This I'm is
the caller.
Hello, good evening.
James. The caller who just called in. I think she's talking about the wrong Douglas.
Right, okay then.
He was entertaining her. You couldn't detect that she was talking about the wrong.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry about that. Kind of a miss that mixed that up. Sorry. Right. It's busy. Hello, good evening. Global Horizon, SLR Radio.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, what's your contribution this evening?
Well, you see, me play with him about a week also, just before him dead, and we play some Pat Kelly.
Mm-hmm.
That means I'm called Pat Kelly.
Right. And
you see, not July when everything done, never play a tribute to Brother Dougie. Mm-hmm. As he bring me in and play Pat Kelly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, live good in July. Yeah, my tribute.
Learning much about his journey, and this is from Aitricia Expressionist. Let's take this call. Good evening, Global Horizon, SLR Radio.
Oh, I'm on now.
Yeah, good evening.
Hello.
Hello. Go ahead.
Yes, this is it's Brother John.
Brother John. Oh, is that Edwards?
Yeah, Edwards. Yeah.
Yeah, James? because Supreme spoke of you earlier on, and obviously your experiences with Brother Dougie. Can you share that with us, with the listeners, please?
Yeah, I could. Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, go right ahead.
Am I on now?
Yeah, you're live. You're on air.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
Go right ahead.
Well, Yeah, well, Fred, this is John Edgar speaking here. The brother just spoke about me and Dougie. I knew Dougie from back in 1988. We went to college together at, in Tottenham College. But Dougie was a person who actually became, he was the actual legend of Tottenham in terms of a community leader. And he really inspired, you know, everybody who he spoke to, because what Dougie used to do is actually plant a seed in the mind of his people. And in planting that seed, what he would do is make you think about not just yourself, but how could you benefit the community? And that's what Dougie was all about. It wasn't about his pocket. It was all about how can you benefit the community. So I remember me and Dougie be walking down the road, and those days I was just going to any shop and spend my money. And Dougie would say, no, brother, spend the money with a black man. Spend the money with a brother man. So Dougie was all about building the community. You know?
Absolutely. And obviously, from all the testimonies that I'm hearing, I'm beginning to run out of words in how to describe, and how should I really describe the kind of person that Dougie is. I don't think that there are enough words in the dictionary to describe the levels at which Dougie operated. And as you can hear, I'm sure that you've been hearing the tributes and the impact and the influence that he has had on many other people's lives and on their journey, and that includes my own, because Dougie has influenced me in ways that I've, you know, he's made me look at myself in ways that I didn't. You know, and I just want to be grateful. I just want to pay condolences to the family, to his mother and all the families who, for thanking you for giving us this man and this gift. I see him as a gift, not only to the community, but to humanity as well.
Yeah, and I think what would be good is to have a fundraise for the family and for his mum, you know. I mean, that would be a good thing if we could organise something like that.
Yes. Yeah, well you know, there's a group that's been formed and that's looking at all ideas like that, and we are in touch with the family in that regard, in terms of things like that. So we are actually working on things like that as well. There's been several ideas that has been put forward in ways that we could remember him and honour him and his legacy in terms of
and
the work.
How I'd describe Dougie is he was a motivational.
Sorry, you dropped you there. I'm kind of a miss you there. If you could, if you get back on, we could continue the conversation. But obviously, it's quite a busy. Hello, good evening. Global Horizon SLR.
Hello.
Can you turn your radio down, please?
Where I'm sorry.
I can hear a lot of feedback. Can you turn your radio down, please?
I'm going to go downstairs.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
My name's Sister Angela from Spice Radio.
Come on, share your, you know, today's program is dedicated to brother, to our late great brother Dougie. What have you got to share with the listener this evening?
Well, hang on 1 minute. Oops. Right. Okay. What it is I actually grew up with him.
Okay, thank you. Okay, go ahead.
Out of each other's house, and we lived in Tottenham at the time, and he lived on one road, we lived on another road, but our house was the hub for all of the West Indian family. So he would come there, and because he was a couple of years older than us, he would talk with us and advise us how to act in school and things like that. And he was just awesome because we all went to the same school. And I went to quite a few of his seminars because I found them interesting and empowering. But one of them I went to was at Parkview, and it was about abuse, mental abuse. And I went there because of the situation, and he invited me because he knew I was going through something like that, because I was looking after my mother with dementia. And he told me, look after your mental health, Angela, look after your physical health. And he warned me, and I didn't heed him. Well, it cut long story short, I had to stop looking after my mum because my mental and physical health went down the road. But Dougie never wavered. He gave me support and everything. Then I went to Parkview about this abuse, and I met Mama Asina, who I absolutely loved the woman's voice when she was on a station. And she helped me through a crisis without even knowing. And I said, Dougie, please introduce me to that lady. Dougie, please. And he said, all right, no problem. So he introduced me to her. She took me under her wing and I became a presenter on Spice Radio. And he never wavered. He always gave me support and said, you're doing well. Yeah, I suggest you do this. Stick as a presenter because that's what you do. You present a topic, present positive topics. You are brilliant at what you're doing. Just keep what you're doing. And I heard his last show, and when, you know, Mikey phoned me 9:30 last week Monday and said, Dougie passed away, I said, stop lying. I just lost the rest of the day. But my heart goes out to his mum and his sister and the rest of his family and all of us, we're called the Clinton Road Posse. We all love and miss him, and the man is a legend. He's a legend. Thank you for letting me talk on the radio.
Yeah, thank you so much for your contribution this evening. I'm sure you've been listening and you can feel the power and the energy of the things that Dougie did. And you can tell from that he was truly a great person. So I just want to thank you for your contribution this evening and for sharing that with us this evening. Thank you very much.
Like I said, I've known him most of my life.
Thank you very much because I really wanted to hear people who knew him as well from that time. So I just want to, you don't know how much I'm thanking you for your contribution this evening. Thank you very much.
Bye.
Yeah, but goodbye. I just want to read a text coming from, there's so many texts here coming from Devonte Gonzel. He won the Flavor Showcasing. Jamos, can you hold the line?
Yeah, no problem.
Please hold the line. I'm reading a text from Devonte Gonzel, who won the Flavor Showcasing showcase, which was the talent contest, and he danced and he won the contest, and he met the brother Dougie as well, and he was about 18, I think 17 at the time, and he also was very impacted and impressed by brother Dougie, and he just wants to say that brother Dougie is a G, and he will always be in my memory, and I will miss, and he always will be missed, and big up Buzzin' B. That is coming from Devonte, who won one of the dance talent competitions at Flavor Showcasing, which Dougie hosted. So and this is the teenager, Devonte, who is sending his respects to the family and his impact with Dougie. Experience. Mm-hmm. Share your experience.
You know, so for me, it hasn't really sunk in yet. You know, it's just too unbelievable for me to get my head around it, you know. But yeah, Dougie was the community. That's the thing. Dougie was the community. He was the one who brought everybody together, you know. He went into subjects that even I felt, no, you should leave them topics alone. Dougie went into all different subjects. You know, he was everywhere and anywhere. He's the only Moses that I know, you know. You know, he was the one who gave me my platform. I think we started SLR together, first couple of shows I was with Dougie, but then he carried it on, and he was the one who gave me my platform to do what I'm doing now, you know.
Yeah, because he also hosted the Speakers Club, which gave people a platform go ahead.
He was one of the founding fathers of the Speakers Club, and he was the co-host with Bridget all the way through. You know, and he brought so many great people. You know, he gave so many people opportunities to speak and display their talents. People like Edison, you know, Professor Sally, Dr. Layla Africa, you know, he brought so many people into our room, so, you know, to enhance our life. You know, Dougie is like he is a living legend, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, he was, because I remember when you, because you, myself, and Lady Essie, we know the concept with the Speakers Club, which was a platform for people to improve their public speaking and things like that, and Dougie hosted that, but he brought us a presence to that event.
And Dougie's sort of skills are underrated as a host. He could make an empty room exciting, you know. I've seen him do it. You know, an empty room with a few people in, he made the whole room exciting. You know, he had a talent when it came to hosting what is really underrated, because he made it look so easy. You know.
Yeah, he really.
You know, definitely, man.
Who
a real person's supposed to be.
Yeah, because he was really and the thing is, Dougie didn't do it he wasn't a glory hunter. Whatever was there was about how the community could benefit, how could people be improved. It wasn't really about him. He never put himself at the center of anything.
No.
I've never saw him did that. Never put himself at the center of anything.
No,
he's always put, it's about how can, cause I remember one time he got me involved at one point. I was his PA and advisor, and I was saying to Dougie, I put my business hat on, and I was saying to Dougie, come on, you need to charge people some more money. And he said to me, brother, he said, no, it's not about the money. I can't do that. I can't do that. It's not about the money.
Sorry, James, I'm going to have to go for a second. I will try and call you back here.
Yeah, okay, no problem. But anyway, Jammers, thank you so much for your job. That was Jammers there, who also work with myself and Dougie on because Dougie hosted the Speakers Club, which was a platform where people could express themselves. Let's take this call. Hello, good evening. Hi, SLR good Radio evening. Global Horizons. Hello, good evening.
Hi, good evening. It's Carolyn.
Is it Carolyn? Yeah.
Carolyn, hi.
Yeah, go right ahead.
Yeah, the reason why I'm calling tonight was just to send my deepest condolences to the family, of course. And also, when I was told, I was in complete shock. I didn't know whether to scream or cry. I was literally speechless when I heard. And it's so, so hard to believe that I will never hear him again on the Find Your Voice show.
Mm-hmm.
My Tuesday nights will never be the same without him. He was the kind of guy that was so approachable, very friendly, kind, considerate, caring. The last time I spoke to him was on the 19th of March, and we had a nice, decent, long conversation. Little did I know that it would be my last conversation that I'd have with him. But I just want to send my deepest condolences to both the SLR family as well as his immediate family.
Mm-hmm.
And we love you, Dougie, wherever you are.
Yeah, thank you so much. I can tell how emotional it is for you, but I just want to thank you that you still had the energy and to call in and give that contribution. I just want to thank you. Yes, just want to, as you can tell, the depth of the feeling and the impact, even me myself was wondering how I was going to cope with this program for my dear brother Dougie, because you can see by the strength of feeling that people have for brother Dougie and stuff. Yes, hello, good evening. SLR Radio, good evening. Global Horizons. Radio. Good evening.
Good evening.
Yes, go ahead. I can hear you. Go ahead. Good evening.
Hi, it's Lady Essie.
Oh, Lady Essie. Oh, right. Good. You got through. So good to hear you. Oh, so good to hear you, Lady Essie. So I know that you've worked with Brother Dougie. You've co-hosted many events with him. So just share your thoughts.
I just want to send my condolences to the family. And I met Dougie back in 2010. Mm-hmm. I was walking along Wood Green High Road, And he stopped me and said, oh, come to my event. It's taking place at 399 High Road, Tottenham High Road. And I thought, okay. And what I loved was the personal touch and actually stopping with me. He spoke to me for about 10 minutes about what he did and what he did in the community. So I came to the event. And from then, I think I started coming to all the community events, because before then, I didn't really attend many community events. It's through Dougie. And I call Dougie the connector, the opportunity maker. Like, from him, that's how I got my first poem published in an anthology. Mm-hmm. He introduced me to the lady that was... That's how I got my first poem published in an anthology. Mm-hmm. He introduced me to the lady that was doing this anthology. And then even getting on the radio, because I told him I wanted to do radio, so he was always encouraging me to call up on his show. Call up, call up, call up. And I said I wanted to speak in public, so he got me to do a first presentation at Selah James Library for Black History Month.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So he saw the potential in my speaking abilities before I did, and that was the skill of Dougie, to see people's potential and their skill that they had and bring it out and coax it out and make you do it and take the steps and hold your hand mm-hmm. until you're ready and he'll push you. And yes, as a host, Dougie was the person that I learned a lot of my hosting skills from. And it was such an honour to share the stage with him at the Speakers Club and at other events I hosted with him. So yeah,
definitely, because you also hosted the Speakers Club Awards with Dougie at the Brandy Grant Centre as well.
Yes, and Speakers Club. And mm-hmm. Dougie taught me a lot about hosting and how to deal with the audience and how to read the audience and how to be on stage and have to have stage presence. So I owe a lot of my hosting skills to Dougie. I learned from him. He was a great teacher.
Yeah, thank you, Lady Essie, for sharing your experience there and you yourself. After that, you excelled in your presentation, because you were presenting the Speakers Club, and then you were presenting. I'm comparing the Rebirth of the Griot, African storytelling event, and now you have your co-hosting Supreme Unconscious.
Yes.
So you really.
Yeah, I call Dougie. Dougie's the person that allowed me to start my speaking journey, that gave me the confidence.
And you're also the president of the Toastmasters International.
I am, and Dougie actually came and visited Tottenham our club Brands. As well. He actually came. He would come to some of our meetings as well, and he would take part. And so yeah, so he's someone inspirational and touch in terms of my speaking journey. So yeah. I thank him dearly for that.
Yeah, thank you very much for your contribution, Lady Essie. Right. Thank you so much for contributing this evening. Yes, we did.
Yes, so thank you for coming through on your word.
Yeah.
And I always know you're a definite man. When you say something, you're going to do it. I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of the whole community. I call it the Dougie community.
That's right. All right? Yeah, better listen. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I believe that Brother Dougie, all right, he's doing it in a different way, but he's also been a messenger, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a great messenger for all of us. And mm-hmm. I remember when you and him and Jammers were doing something with Dawn.
Oh, at, yes, yes.
The Marcus Garvey Library, and you told me about it. You said, oh, you know, Dawn told me. And she said, get in touch with James, because James is the chairman and Brother Dougie is there. Mr. Brother Dougie is there? She said, yes, Mr. Ulmer, come in. Yeah. And turn up I did, and my word, as usual, Brother Dougie, I don't know the word. Listen, I'm a man of words, as you know.
Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm.
I'm never lost for words.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think the words that Brother Dougie deserves is even been actually in the so-called dictionary.
Yeah, exactly. I was saying the same thing.
All right. Mm-hmm. He's indescribable. Mm. That's how I find him. Indescribable. So I'm going to say this before I can even say any more words. So listen to this. Indescribable. That's what you are. Just incredible. You are a guiding star. When you let it out, my brother, asking for me and my voice, I look around me and I know I've got only one choice. I'll find my voice. Oh, brother, I'll find my voice. I have a choice. You gave me choice. I'll find my voice. And you are indescribable. That's my tribute to my virgin, you know? That's my tribute to my virgin.
Yeah, very moving indeed, and very different. Very moving indeed, Lyndon.
I feel it, man. I feel it. Mm. I don't be sad, you know. I'm not sad. Yeah, I know we won't see him in the flesh again. But you see, I want to say this. And Brother Dougie, thank you for the opportunity for me to open my big mouth and tell everybody that death doesn't exist.
Mm.
You understand? What exists are the fantastic memories that we have of Brother Dougie.
Mm.
It will never fade. To winter, autumn, winter, you know, spring, summer, whatever, whichever way we are in this planet, with whomever we are, I can feel your magnificence, my brother.
Mm.
I can feel your presence, my brother. I thank you so much for bigging me up for a lot of things that lots of other people don't even see me. The things that Dougie seen me, and he tell me. I remember one time when I came to that same thing at Marcus Garvey Library, right? I had won second prize. I didn't even know there was any prizes.
Yeah, it was the Speakers Club. Yeah.
At when Don was the host, you know.
Mm-hmm.
At the Marcus Garvey Library, was it the Speakers Club? I think
it was Speakers Club.
That's the first time I'd heard of the Speakers Club, because yes, it was Iman Jamas and yourself and other people.
Yeah, Lady Essie and
Lady Essie and that, right.
Mm.
So everywhere I go, and I heard somebody say it, I can't remember if it was Esketar, the brother from Alkan Gulan, yeah,
mm-hmm.
The brother from there, who was talking about everywhere you go, Dougie's known. North, south, east, west, Dougie is known.
Mm.
Well, they say it's only good people that have a reputation, you know.
Mm.
Right, a high reputation.
Mm.
We're not talking about normal, because with Brother Dougie, nothing was normal.
Absolutely, right? Absolutely.
Brother Dougie was always exaggerated, over the top.
Mm-hmm.
Demanding in his very simple, pleasant way.
Yes,
that
absolutely.
He brought about change.
Absolutely.
Brother Dougie coming like the weather.
Yeah.
You understand? Mm-hmm. I tell you, one of the favorite things that I love to hear Brother Dougie says, now then, and then afterwards.
Yeah, that's it.
He tells you, you know, you need to pay attention, because all the people here have been invited, but they have decided to make their way to this warm amount of vibrations Brother Dougie bring.
Mm.
I'm totally animated by Brother Dougie. You mentioned his smile earlier on, and some other people too.
Mm.
I mean, let me bring that into my focus and my tribute. Brother Dougie, you see your smile? We can see it for miles and miles and miles. We will carry that smile. Your voice is heard without your physical presence. Everything you've done is a huge tribute to teach others that on this planet there is more prophets, there are more. That on this planet, there is more prophets. There are more men. Not just hooray, because we're not hearing that. We are shouting, Al-Kebolon. We're shouting, Ubuntu. We are shouting, Brother Dougie. And we are shouting, thank you for helping Iman to find our voice.
Thank you, Brother Lyndon. A very moving, and powerful tribute indeed.
All right, my brother.
Thank you.
Cool.
Yeah, that was Brother Lynn pressing his experience with Dougie. And as you said, it is almost indescribable. Let's take this call again. Hello, good evening.
Greetings.
Oh, that's it's Jammers again.
Yeah. Sorry, I had to get cut off for some.
Yeah. As you've heard,
it's all over the place, and he didn't even drive. Mm. You know, he had so many big events.
Mm.
You know, Dougie's a person who touched everybody's heart. You know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you know, he gave me the platform to do what I'm doing. I think he gave many up.
Because you know that, but myself and you and Lady Essie and a lot of us, we work so closely with Brother Dougie, and that's why for me, it had such a deep impact on myself, and I didn't even know how I could have done this today. But I could hear Brother Dougie saying, "Go on, Buzzinbi, you will gain your strength. So just go on and do it." And that's why that I decided. Because when I see Brother Dougie being able to balance and all the things that he was doing, it was just one thing after the other. I have to say, I didn't know how he did it.
Yeah.
No.
Hello?
Yeah. I'm listening, yeah.
There's no such word as can't in his language.
No.
You know, any task, he was just working out how to do it. He didn't know the meaning of something can't be done.
And he didn't, when it comes to, you know, because, you know, as you know, because you do events as well, and you organize events, and I'm also involved in events myself. And as you do, you know that there are challenges and there are things that doesn't always work your way. Dougie is not the kind of person that would be there mourning about it. He would say, "How would you do it better the next time?"
That's right, yeah.
That's what he would say. He wouldn't be quivering and mourning about it. He would say, "How can we do it better next time? How can you do it differently next time?" That was the measure of the man. And from that, I got my inspiration in terms of events. You know, he kind of taught me that do it. It's not about mourning and having a go at other people. Just ask them how they would do it better the next time.
Yes.
And I got that particular thing. I really took that from Brother Dougie.
And he was like a silent motivator. It's like you didn't even realize it, but he was the one who was giving you your courage and your enthusiasm.
And your strength.
Yeah, and as Linda said, his smile, when he smiled, you know, so that you was on the right track, you know what I mean?
Yes, that's it, you know. And yes, you know, what can we say? I think, as Star said, that we have to, you know, because the strengthful feeling is so great, we can't let it go to waste, as Star said. We got to come forward and make sure that his legacy lives on, you know, in the things that he did and the things that he believed. We cannot let it die. We cannot let the legacy go. We got to maintain his legacy.
Definitely.
Yeah, most definitely. But Jammers, I just want to thank you again for calling back and completing your contribution.
Yeah, and I know you've got other callers in a short time, so thanks for putting on the show, and I'll be listening keenly, yeah?
Yeah, thank you very much, Jammers. Thank you.
Okay, take care.
Thank you. Bye. Yeah, that was Jammers calling back to complete his contribution to Brother Dougie. I've got about, there's so many texts coming in the studio here this evening to share. This is coming from 548. It said, "This is Brother Kojo. I was deeply saddened when I heard the news of Brother Dougie passing, as he was very close to me and my family, and I have known him from school because we all went to the same school, called Parkview Academy. It was Langham School back then. Back in the day, we spent a lot of time together, and he came around to my house and I was by his, and we would party together, reason and so forth. When I lost both my father and my mother, he was a tower of strength to me. I could say so much, but I will miss him deeply." And that's coming from Kojo. We have another text. The phone lines are free, so anyone who wants to call in, 07984 931588. He said, I'm so sorry to say condolences to all the families that have left, and Amen. That is coming from Danite. And we have another one coming from all right, we have another text here coming from 167. Let's take this call. Hello, good evening, SLR Radio, Global Horizons. Good evening.
Hello.
Good evening.
Hello, it's Vasco. Can you hear me?
It's Vasco? Yeah, I can hear you loud and clear.
Good show. I've been trying to get through for the last hour, but it's been manic.
It has been, as you can imagine, because of the nature and obviously the caliber of the person who we are honoring this evening. So, yes, so what's share with the listeners, what's your experience and your thoughts of Brother Dougie?
Well, I met Dougie about 8 years ago at a seminar. And then when he found out that I was into presentations, especially on the prostate, he invited me to come to Parkview Academy and do a presentation for him on the prostate. And I did that, and then he invited me onto his radio program on SLR, and I was a regular guest on his program for about 2 years. Mm-hmm. And he started coming to some of my presentations as well. And what struck me about him was his humility. You know, I have never heard him raise his voice, use a four-letter word. He was so humble and so calm. And anyone who was associated with him would have experienced that. He never put anyone down. He always tried to, as they say, big people up. And to have done what he did at Parkview and then on SLR Radio, and I gather from those who knew him before that he was also an activist in other areas as well. You know, it was a pleasure being around him and talking to him and, you know, associating with him in many different ways. Mm-hmm. But he would also, what impressed me as well is that he was not only interested in health, but he was interested in Black history and generally aware of the world around him and how things operated in this world. Mm-hmm. And that's what I liked about him. And, you know, we talk quite a lot. And sometimes on a Tuesday night, he would phone me up about a few minutes before his show started and would say to me, can you give me 20 minutes tonight, you know? And I would stop everything I was doing and give him 20 minutes. He was that kind of person that if he called on you, you responded positively to him the same way you expected him to respond to you, and he would as well.
Yeah, and Vasco, of course, I remember you did a big event with him, which was, you were, you know, to do with prostate cancer, because he was very keen on making sure, particularly Black men, because the rate of that was affecting Black men in a very high way. And I remember he did an event on that, and you were one of the speakers there.
Yes, I actually did a full presentation at Parkview Academy for him, and that was what I think cemented the relationship between us. But what I would like to do for the next minute or so is just to take this into a slightly different realm. Mm-hmm. And say, has he really left us? Because I don't think he has. Mm. Three reasons I'm saying this. Firstly, his legacy is going to live on. So in that way, he will still be with us, although he will not be physically with us as a human being. Secondly, we know that when people pass from this scene, they transition into another realm. So what is we would perceive as death is really a rebirth into another dimension. So in that regard, he's also living on. But also, because the ancestors live on in us, and he has now become an ancestor. He too, in this regard, is living on in us. So those are the three ways I think that he is still with us, although physically he has passed.
Yes, thank you, Vasco Stevenson.